What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Daily here from Nation Fusion, and today I have another MRE review for you. This time, Meal Kit Supply has hooked us up with a breakfast menu, menu 11, sausage patty with hash browns. So we're gonna bust this thing open, try everything, and give you our opinions on the breakfast menu for Meal Kit Supply. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, so here we go. We got the MRE from Meal Kit Supply. As I said, this one is menu number 11, sausage patty with hash browns. So we're gonna try and use the pull tab here. Looks like it's right there, and it will just should just pull apart. There we go. This one's another double pack. So that's the outer pack there. And then here is our inner pack. This one should just, this has just little tear tabs at the top. And let's see what we got. So the first thing we have up is maybe the sausage. Pork sausage patty, maple flavored. So we have that there. The next thing we have is a wheat snack bread. Now, I really do like wheat snack bread. I have not had it in a Meal Kit Supply MRE yet, so I'm kind of excited to see what their wheat snack bread is kind of like. Next up, we have a carbohydrate electrolyte beverage powder. This one's orange. Orange was pretty good last time. I did enjoy that, so we have that there. We have the hash brown nutritional facts. We have our flameless ration heater, the good kind. Next up, we have our accessory pack, which we'll go through and see what's included in there. I already see some coffee, so that was pretty much expected. Next up, we have blackberry jam. Now, this is different. This is pretty cool. This is kind of a first for the channel. Never had blackberry jam on the channel. We'll have some of that on the wheat snack bread, kind of see what that's all about. I'm pretty excited. I don't think I've ever had blackberry jam. I'm a very, once I find foods I like, I kind of stick with those kind of guy. Next up is a cocoa beverage powder. This is kind of like a chocolate drink. So that's what we have right there. And one of the fill pouches, so you just pull this tab off, fill it up to this line here, and then shake, and you're good to go. You don't have to have specifically like measured out water or anything, just fill it to the line. Next up, we have a chocolate chip toaster pastry, which I'm believing is going to be kind of a Pop-Tart. Now, I'm feeling already like this is kind of more stuff than we had in the last couple MREs. I mean, we have a snack bread, a chocolate chip toaster thing, we have the jam, we have two drinks, we have our main course, and we still have our hash browns, which are hash browns with bacon in this package. So I feel like we got a little more in our food area today. So there's the outer sleeve where we're gonna cook all of this, and that's kind of what we're looking like broken down here. Are these items. We have our two different beverages here. We have our chocolate chip toaster pastry. We have our bread and jam. We have our entree, which is these two packages together. And we have our accessory pack, which we're just gonna go ahead and bust open right now. These are pretty much always the same. The only thing that differs in these accessory packs are kind of like how much salt, pepper, like spices that you get. So let's see what we got here. So fresh nap. We have a deep, rich coffee. We have one iodized salt, one pepper package. We have two sugars. We have a coffee creamer and a paper towel. So we're gonna go ahead and get all of this opened up and put onto a tray. We're gonna get some of the food heated up, and we'll be right back. All right, guys, so first things first, we're gonna go ahead and mix up this coffee. We're gonna mix it up in our coffee mug here. This is Darth Vader. So let's go ahead and get this stuff in here. I brought 2 cups of water. I didn't measure out anything, and I just want to see if 2 cups of water is pretty much what you need to make up everything in this this MRE here. So let's see how far 2 cups gets us, which is, you know, about what you can expect to have out in, you know, a camping situation, or if you're using these personally for military use or something like that. You can usually get around 2 cups of water pretty easily, whether from bottles or in your mess hall, that kind of thing. So let's see. Ooh, this coffee is not, this coffee is stuck together. This might be 2006 as far as the date goes. Wow, I'm not super happy with the outturn of this coffee. I'll show you guys here in just a second. You should be able to see. First of all, on my fingers, it's very like stuck and sticky. And then if you look inside, it's very like, you see the flakes? It's very flaky. It smells really bitter as well. Let's hope that that is good. So here's our 2 cups of water. We're going to pour just enough to fill up to the medium point of this, which that takes us down to about a cup. So that's what we got in there. We'll use our MRE spoon to kind of stir this up. This might be 2006. I'm not sure. All I know is usually, even with some of the older MREs I have, usually that instant coffee is not like that. It was very, very sticky, and it didn't smell that good. But anyway, that's in there, that's mixing up. We're gonna move on to our next drink, which is going to be this beverage powder. That's going in this cup. This cup requires 12 ounces. So you might actually need a little more than 2 cups. At least for this particular MRE. So there's that, 12 ounces. This thing has measuring increments on the side, so we'll use that to fill up to 12 ounces. All right, yeah, not enough. So that's as far as we got. We'll let that stir up. I'll get some more water, and I'll give you guys kind of a solid determination on how much water you need for this particular MRE. All right, next up on our adventure here into this MRE, we're gonna mix up the cocoa beverage powder, and then this is actually gonna go into here so you guys can kind of see what it looks like. So far we've got 12 ounces of water, which is a cup, for those of you who don't know. I don't know if everywhere in the world uses cups and ounces. Maybe they do, maybe they don't. If you don't, and I'm just ignorant, that's about a cup of water. This is about 8 ounces or so. And so this is going to be an additional 6. So that's where we're going to be at with water usage so far. Then we still have to fill the flameless ration heater as well. So we'll be back when this is all mixed up. Alright guys, so here we go. We're going to pour the cocoa beverage powder, which is like a chocolate milk or hot chocolate type of thing. We're going to pour that into this cup here, which I'll put on camera for you. And there we go. Simple, small little treat, basically. That'll go over there, and that's what you're looking like. Just a little bit of, I mean, warm this up, you heat this up, this is a good little swig of hot chocolate. It smells good too. It smells just like some hot cocoa mix. So we have our 3 drinks right here. We have our coffee in this container. Where are we at? Over here in this one, we've got our orange electrolyte powder, Gatorade type thing, and then we have our cocoa beverage powder there. So let me pan the camera back up here so you guys can see what we have going on here. So first up, we'll get these out of the way. We're going to go ahead and open up. Before we open these up, I'm going to get this cooking so that when we're done with this, this will be ready for you guys. So let's do that real quick. All right, guys, so we have this going. We'll let you listen. So this flameless ration heater is working, and I can confirm I got both of the entree pieces inside of here. So the hash browns and the whatever the hell that thing is, the ham thing, ham patty or sausage patty. They're both in there. They're both cooking. So we're going to put this on a rock or something, and then we're going to open up these side items. All right, guys. So let's check out this toaster pastry chocolate chip, which is just going to be a chocolate chip Pop-Tart. Here we go. Okay, so we're open there. We're getting this out without breaking it. So these things usually, they fall apart pretty easy. This one actually made it out alive. And while looking not the best, it actually looks kind of good. I mean, as far as its physical form not looking the best, it is in pretty good shape. And this is actually one of my favorite types of Pop-Tarts. I love unfrosted Pop-Tarts with maybe just like a drizzle. Or even if it's, you know, strawberry, I like those unfrosted. So this is good. This is a... That's a nice looking piece to this MRE, and that's good for breakfast. It's a good breakfast item. That is where these things are starting to come together. With one of my first meal kit supply reviews, I wasn't sure exactly how they were gonna handle, you know, putting these different MREs together, and, you know, were they going to be not only tasting good, but fit together with other components. And this one is looking like it's gonna be perfect. So here's the wheat snack bread. We got, look at that, kind of looks like a little piece of toast, doesn't it? Look at that. So we got the wheat snack bread there. Oh, it smells so good. I love the wheat snack bread, I really do. It's got a little bit of silica gel for you guys to eat on. So we got that. We've got the blackberry jam that's coming on right now. So we're just gonna knead this up just a bit. We're gonna tear down the side line here. And there you go. That's the blackberry jam you're getting right there. Let's go ahead and get it out onto this wheat snack bread. So there you go. That's what you're looking like. I'm going to go ahead and taste a bit. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. It's really strong. And it tastes like there's little bits of berries in it as well. This is actually really, really good, guys. You know, a lot of people will tell you and say, you know, this or that. But I can tell you right now, no bullshit about it. This actually tastes really good. So what I want to do is I want to get this jam spread across this wheat snack bread here. And you know what? What's probably really good is if you saved a little bit of this this jam and actually put it across the you can see the little bits of like berry in there. If you put that across the hash browns, I bet you will be really, really good. So there's, you got those two items there. Let's go ahead and check on our entree here. It feels pretty hot. We'll get the bottom one out first. This one I'm not sure is completely done. This is our sausage patty. Nah, it needs a little bit longer in there. But these hash browns, I can tell you, these are done. So we'll pull these out. Oh yeah, those are hot. Hot, hot, hot. See the steam coming off there. So we'll get this in here. In fact, we'll get it the side that didn't get much attention or much love. We'll get that side down. We'll fold her back up. We'll let that cook while we put this out onto the tray, and we'll go from there. So we're gonna put the hash browns here, or about right here in frame, so you guys can see. We'll spread this a little bit and see how our hash browns look. Hopefully these aren't too watery. It looks like they are. They're pretty watery. Let's see what it looks like on our tray here. All right, so this is our hash browns with bacon. It smells good. It doesn't smell bad. All right, so that's our hash browns. I think maybe once you mix it up, the kind of wateriness will not be so bad. But, you know, you got to keep these things kind of hydrated. You know, you got the bacon and stuff in there. So, I mean, let's just go ahead and try a little bit of this on its own before we get our sausage patty in there. And this is what you're looking at. You've got a nice good helping of hash brown there. It's a little bland. I'd say just by itself, it's a little bland. There are some kind of like, some kind of vegetable in there. I'm assuming maybe like some corn or some carrots or something. Let's just try and spice it up here with a little bit of this. We'll put the pepper in there. And then we'll put a little bit of the salt. Not much. I prefer pepper over salt. My own preference. So let's go ahead and get that mixed up and see if that does any favors for the flavor. Okay, so let's see. Let's check it out. Got everything mixed up there. There's a nice good bite. We got some kind of vegetable there on it as well. Oh, that's the piece of bacon. You know, that helps a little bit. I gotta say, for the potatoes, they remind me a little bit about the all gratin potatoes that we had earlier, which are not my favorite. They have that kind of texture. But it's still edible. It's a little more soupy than I would have liked it. I mean, just it's a little in excess is what I'm trying to say. But that's the helping you get right there. And then let's throw this sausage patty on it and see if that helps us out with the flavor as well. Because this sausage patty is in, it's maple flavored. So that should go well with the bacon. So here it is. It's a little wet right now, so it's going to be tough to kind of get out. Give me a second. All right, so here we go. This is our sausage patty. Let's see if I can get this into frame here for you guys. You'll have to ignore if there's any background noise. You're going to have to ignore it, guys. I'm super sorry, but there's a lot of inconsiderateness going on around here today. But that is our sausage patty. It looks good, actually. I am not a fan of sausage, but that's nice. It's dripping a bit. So let's get that on there. It's got a little bit of juice in there. I'm assuming that's the maple flavoring, so we're going to actually add that on to our tray here. All right, so, I mean, it looks pretty good. Again, this particular meal is a little more soupy than I would have liked, but I'm assuming, you know, that's the idea of it. This is kind of what you want to do. You want to get your hash brown here, maybe pour, you know, some of the hash browns in the packaging with this sausage if you don't have a tray. Maybe you're out camping or something. And then, I mean, let's just try it. So, that's what we're looking at. That is a piece of the sausage, bunch of the hash brown. Wow, that's actually really good. That is a full-flavored piece of sausage. It's juicy. It's got a little bit of spice to it. This honey really helps, and it blends well with the potatoes. It really does. Everything kind of fits. There's a little bits of bacon in there as well. Everything tastes real good. So overall, the entree is really good. I think this is gonna be very, very filling. I mean, you got a lot of juice to deal with though. So you definitely need a tray with a divider in there. Don't be like me. Don't use a sheet. You need a real tray with some dividers and stuff like that. Maybe I will get one. So far, this series has not taken off enough. I haven't done enough of these MRE reviews to warrant getting a tray. But hopefully, if I can keep working with Meal Kit Supply and, you know, any MREs that people send me, maybe I'll get one. But, yeah, this is really good. And I really don't like sausage. I don't eat sausage. I will eat this whole thing. Next up, let's try our wheat snack bread. One of my favorites. with the blackberry jam. So the wheat snack bread, it has a good, great texture to it. It kind of melts in your mouth. It doesn't have a bad taste. It goes really, really well with that blackberry jam. That's a killer combination right there. We're going to try and wash that down with a little bit of the coffee. Now, I'm going to go ahead and tell you right now, that coffee is it's way more bitter than I expected it to be. I think maybe either the packaging for the coffee was going bad, or something happened to it, or maybe it wasn't stored in a great place, but the coffee is not great. It's still drinkable. I think you put enough sugar in there, you can drink anything, you know, that tastes bad, but, you know, it's not terrible, but it's definitely not perfect like the other one was. The orange beverage powder. Great. Dissolved, again, just like usual. Nice Gatorade, Powerade type of taste for it. And this is going to be kind of to wash everything down. You definitely want to hang on to that for the end of the meal. The next up is our cocoa beverage mix. That's just delicious. This is just like a package of hot chocolate. I mean, make sure this thing's hot. You could even probably fill this up a little over 6 if you wanted to, like a little bit extra. Maybe you could go to 8 and it would still have some great flavor. That's, I mean, you can even see some kind of going into the bottom there. So, I mean, you add a little bit more water to that, that gives you a little more, and then, you know, it still tastes good. Last up is our Pop-Tart kind of thing, or toaster pastry for copyright reasons. And this is, you know, pretty simple. It's a chocolate-filled Pop-Tart, and it's got little chocolate chips in it, and it's got a chocolate drizzle on the top. That tastes great. So you got a lot of sugar with this particular one. You got, you know, your starch with your bread. You got your starch in your potatoes. You got some protein. You've got your drinks. This is a good meal. This is a perfect a perfect representation of what an MRE should look like. Everything complements each other, everything tastes good, and overall it's very filling. These two bread items are definitely going to fill you up if this does not. And then you've got your drinks to wash it down. I enjoyed this one. Definitely good job to Meal Kit Supply for putting this one together. Sounds like some good thought went into it, and we definitely appreciate them sending us a breakfast item. Hopefully they can send us some more MREs in the future. I'd really like to sample the entire menu. I don't know if that is going to be possible, but hopefully we can work something out where I can get more than just a couple. The two that I reviewed for you guys already are so close together with each other, you know, one being a you know, an Italian thing, and then you've got the vegetarian lasagna. Those are really, really similar in scope. So hopefully they like working with me. Hopefully you guys get enough information from these reviews. Get on board with what Meal Kit Supply is doing. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know in the comments down below any MREs you'd like to see reviewed, or if you'd like to send me an MRE to check out, I'd be happy to do it on camera. This is what you get for Meal Kit Supply at menu number 11, sausage patty with hash browns. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Nation Fusion TV.